Polymyositis is a rare autoimmune disease that results in striated muscle inflammation. In dermatomyositis, the same features occur, but with characteristic skin changes too. The exact aetiology of both these diseases are unknown, but specific viruses, like Coxsackie, have been implicated in their pathogenesis. Initially, people experience proximal muscle weakness affecting the shoulder and pelvic girdle, which is often, but not always, painful. This can progress to muscle wasting, resulting in difficulty climbing stairs or standing up from a chair. Much like other autoimmune diseases, systemic features like fever, weight loss, and fatigue are common. Without treatment, there's often progressive involvement of the pharyngeal muscles and the muscles of respiration, leading to dysphonia and respiratory failure. It's also important to remember that interstitial lung disease can occur in up to 30% of patients. On top of these features, people with dermatomyositis have dermatological stigmata too. The two main features to remember are Gottron's papules and a heliotrope rash. Gottron's papules are small purple raised lesions on the tops of the small joints of the hands, while a heliotrope rash is a purple bilateral discoloration of the upper eyelids with swelling of the surrounding skin. Bloods might show an elevated creatinine kinase, which might be used to measure disease activity. Furthermore, you might see a raised ESR and CRP with positive autoantibodies, specifically ANA, anti-JO1, and anti-Me2. However, the most important investigation for both these diseases is a muscle biopsy, which would show inflammatory infiltrates and necrosis. Both these diseases convey an increased risk of a broad range of cancers, so screening for an underlying malignancy should be routinely undertaken. The mainstay of treatment is oral glucocorticoids with prednisolone. However, more immunosuppression might be needed with the use of DMARDs like methotrexate. Furthermore, in the acute setting, where there's respiratory involvement, additional support with methylprednisolone might be indicated too. I remember all of this by thinking that polymyositis and dermatomyositis are one, but kind of two diseases. That makes me remember that the autoantibodies are anti-JO1, but also anti-Me2. I also remember this phrase, dermatologists get hard when managing rashes. This helps me to remember that dermatomyositis presents with Gottron's papules, a heliotrope rash, and proximal weakness. It's investigated with a muscle biopsy and can progress to respiratory involvement too. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And please hit that little dingly thing as well next to the subscribe button. It helps heaps.